This episode is brought to you in collaboration with Kring. Kring is the venture studio that I'm a partner in and where we build health and well-being ventures. So we try and take some of the newest knowledge. Some of it I learn here on the podcast by interviewing really cool guests. And then we want to turn it into ventures that can really impact a lot of people. And we're always looking for the best entrepreneurs to start these companies with. So if you're interested in starting a health and well-being venture, then please check out kring.com. And with that, let's get into this episode. Thank you so much for spending some time with me again. Today, I'll talk about what I have learned from the first four episodes and how I've tried to implement some of the things from the guest and what I've learned from that. And the first episode was with Niels Vium, who is an expert on performance. And one thing that I took away was his morning smoothie. And one of my lessons from that was that I've been doing this morning smoothie, but I also figured out that I was making it so convenient to eat that every single day, and that was apparently not that good for me. I took an IgG4 intolerance blood test that said I had some challenges with ginger. So despite using this awesome smoothie every single day and eating that, it wasn't the best thing for me. So it was good to get the smoothie, but it's very important to have a balanced diet and don't eat the same thing every single day for a year. But for me, it was just so easy to have the smoothie and eat it every single year. The second thing was the Pomodoro technique that he talked about. The Pomodoro technique is basically that you work really focused for 25 minutes, no interruptions, just on one task, and then you take a 5 minute break. And no matter how deep you are in that task, you take that break after those 25 minutes. I haven't been able to find any studies saying that this is really working that well, but a lot of people are swearing to using this method, and I use it very often at my work and find it very beneficial. The second episode was with Daniel Espeland, and Daniel is very much into food and what you can use to enhance your performance and basically feel good. And some of the things I learned from him was that you shouldn't eat bottom mushrooms, uncooked, as they can actually give you a headache. So that's the mushroom that you see, like the white one with the little, round head that many of us use. It's fine if you cook it, but otherwise it's actually not the best for you. But there is a lot of good mushrooms out there. So there's the reishi powder. I've used that a little bit for sleep from Four Sigmatic. I haven't been able to feel a big difference from it. And I haven't read the deep studies, but one of my friends that's been using has really felt a big difference. And that goes back to most of the stuff we're discussing. Something works for some people, it doesn't necessarily work for everyone. The other thing was lion's mane that you can use for focus, kind of the same way as coffee. I use that once in a while as well. And again, I don't feel the biggest difference compared to other people. I don't drink coffee either. My energy level is normally really high, but I still use the lion's mane once in a while. And then there's chaga. I use that for my smoothies. It's really high in antioxidants. The last thing from his episode was the oyster mushrooms and shiitake mushrooms that I now implement and use instead of meat for several of my dishes. Another of my first interviews was with Alaxander, Avanth. We discussed a lot about how to be mindful. So he did a TED talk on how to use your phone mindfully. So I've now implemented Apple's or the iPhone settings in regards to how much I can be on social media very strategically. So I now have a blocker that comes up if I've spent more than 10 minutes on Instagram a day, or I think it's 10 or 20 minutes as well on Messenger. And then I also have that it blocks most of my apps at 10 o'clock. It's, for me, working super well. It kind of reminds me that I should take those breaks. I can still go into the apps. I just need to do a bit more putting in my password and so on. A second thing was really setting intentions for the day. So I write my gratitude journal every single day. 3 things I'm grateful for before I go to bed. And then what Alaxander added was really taking the time to also set an intention for the next day. So what is your intention for the next day? I try to use it. I haven't been able to use it every single day, but I can see it's definitely having a positive impact that I'm very mindful of. What is it that I want out of the next day? Be close with some friends, get some tasks done, things like that. And then I have been struggling with getting started on meditation for ages. So I tried several apps, but he mentioned Insight Timer, which I hadn't tried before. I tried Headspace. I even paid for it to make sure that I was going to use it for a yearly subscription. That didn't help. I couldn't get started. But then he suggested Inside Timer, and I used that and made it super simple for me to succeed. So I set the goal of just doing 3 minutes a day of meditation, and that has really made an impact for me. I have now been meditating almost every day, only with sometimes that I have a 1 day break, for the last, I think, 3 or 4 months. And now I do more than 3 minutes. So that's been really helpful for me as well. The last interview that I want to talk about today is the interview with Sarah Hemmeken. So that's the only episode I have on the podcast that's in Danish. And Sarah talked about how do you figure out what you really want to do. And she actually had the biggest difference on my normal day-to-day routine. It wasn't the main topic, but we talked about how do you get all of the things done you want to get done in the day when you're really busy and you have kids. And she told me that she did all of her smoothie prepping once a week. Such a simple thing where I used to do smoothie prepping every single morning. Instead, now I do every second week. I chop up my smoothies, put them into bags in the freezer for 2 weeks. And that's really been a game changer time-wise that gives me more time and more energy to focus on what really matters. Just remember not doing the exact same smoothie every single day. Another really good question that Sarah asked, and I think is worth for you to ask yourself as well, is when you're thinking about what do you really want to do? So you asked the question of, what would you do if you couldn't fail? And I think that question is really worth asking yourself, because that tells you something about what direction you might want to go. So that was all for me this time. Super short episode. I'd love to get your feedback on if this is helpful for you or not. But these were my experiences from the first 4 episodes and how I've used some of the advice from the guest on the podcast. And I look very much forward to talking to you again. And please interact. Tell me what you want more of.